In this video, we're talking about the ChatGPT Projects functionality. This is something that's just become available to free users, and it's really exciting. You may have been using ChatGPT like this, lots of individual chats in the sidebar. Whenever you have a new task to do, you start a new chat, you enter your instructions and your context, and you do that each time. And so you end up with endless chats and it's a bit of a mess. Imagine what this will look like after you've been using ChatGPT for a few months or years. It will be a proper mess. And that's why the Projects functionality is so useful. If you're new here, I'm Aga. I've been working in tech for more than 15 years and I also run my own online education business with more than 1.5 million followers across social media. So make sure you subscribe and let's get this video started. So what are ChatGPT projects? Projects are like folders inside ChatGPT where you can keep everything related to a topic or a task in one place. Imagine you're working on a marketing campaign, writing a book, or planning a trip. Instead of starting a new chat every time, you create a project instead. And then you do all your work relating to that topic inside that project to keep it separate from your other chats. But it gets even better. Inside that project, ChatGPT can also remember all the files, notes, and progress, so you don't have to re-explain everything over and over again. But let me give you some actual examples of how this can be useful to you. The first one is content repurposing. This is something that can be incredibly useful if you work with content a lot. So if you work in communications, marketing, social media, if you run your own business, or if you're a teacher, there is always potential for content repurposing. So here's what happens. Imagine you're working on a marketing campaign for garden furniture. The campaign is going to run across 6 months, so you need lots of content. But you've done this many times before in previous years, so you know exactly who your ideal customer is, what their user needs are, what pain points they're experiencing. You know your brand voice already, and you've written lots of different blog posts and social media posts about this already. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna open a new project just here in your sidebar and you're gonna give it a name. So I'm going to call it blog post content because it's gonna be the project that I want to use for storing all of my blog post work. Create project, and here we go. You can change this icon. So because this project is about writing, I'm going to give it this little icon and then I'm going to change it to yellow because that's my favorite color. And then basically what happens here is you're going to be adding files with all the contextual information that you want to give ChatGPT to help it understand the context of what you'll be asking it. So you can add here things like documents, code files, images, and more. So you probably already have lots of documents like this saved somewhere else outside of ChatGPT. Things like user personas, lists of pain points, list of user needs, anything to do with the style that you usually use when writing, the brand tone of voice, any sort of previous content that you've written. So you may have some PDFs or Google Docs where you've saved blog posts that you've written on this topic, any social media content that you've published. So anything you give it is essentially providing context for the project that can be used when creating anything inside that project. So you click add files. So you can see one file has been added. And ChatGPT will be able to refer to those files whilst working on your content. So the other useful thing when working with a project is that you can add instructions relating specifically to this project. So once you're inside the project, you just click these three dots and add instructions. And basically, this is just additional context that you can add to this project to specify how you want ChatGPT to respond. So it gives you an example here, like respond in Spanish, reference the latest JavaScript documentation, keep answers short and focused. So if you want to add some instructions that will basically apply to any output that ChatGPT creates in this project, this is the place to do it. So then you save your instructions and you're ready to go. And that is a major benefit of ChatGPT projects. You feed the contextual information once, and you don't have to do that again for any new chats inside that project. Once you've got the context ready, you can then start a chat and ask it, for example, to create a list of blog post ideas focused on conversion and based around the pain points and the user needs of the customer base. So ChatGPT will then refer to all the files that you have uploaded as part of your contextual information in order to come up with that list. So as long as you continue to work inside that project, ChatGPT will remember everything that's happened previously, and it will be able to use it as further contextual information when creating any future output. The other useful thing is that inside a project, ChatGPT can also reference other chats that have been created inside that project. So this is actually dependent on the plan that you're on. So the best thing to do is to go to the OpenAI guidance and actually search for the guidance relating to your plan, because these things can change really quickly. So at the moment, it says that for Plus and Pro users, ChatGPT can reference previous chats within a project to deliver more relevant, focused responses. So what is the difference between a project and a custom GPT? And I'm going to make a separate video about custom GPTs, so I'm not going to go into too much detail here, but just to simplify it, you can think of a custom GPT like an AI agent that you have configured with specific instructions and behaviors, and that always acts in a certain way or knows a specific knowledge base. So imagine that you run a blog with a group of your friends where you publish horror stories every week, and those stories are written in a very particular style. So for that purpose, you can create a custom GPT, which is a separate instance of ChatGPT, so it's outside of the main ChatGPT that you're using, and it's been trained on the style and the tone of voice that you need for those stories. So you can share that with all of your friends, and each of you can publish a story that is consistent with any previous story that has been written by that specific custom GPT. A project is similar to that, but it's a bit different. Think of it more like a workspace where you organize all the different things that you're working on. It's all inside your ChatGPT, so you don't have to go anywhere else. And you can have multiple different projects with multiple different goals and styles and instructions inside ChatGPT. So for example, if you're writing a PhD research paper, then you can keep all your files, notes, PDFs inside that project, and you can use it for that specific purpose. But you may also have a separate project inside ChatGPT, which is about something completely different, like planning a trip or learning a language. So as you can see, projects can really transform ChatGPT from a simple Q&A tool that can get a bit messy into a powerful tool that delivers consistent and high quality results each time, and it saves you lots of time. If this video helped you, make sure you leave me a comment and let me know what you're using ChatGPT projects for. And don't forget to subscribe to my free newsletter, where I share my top tips on how you can use AI at work and in your everyday life. And I'll see you next time. Bye.